The next company we have is Rozgar, in a very similar space like Baba Job, B2B. We have Mr. Ajay Mohapatra. Please welcome.
Thanks a lot. Basically, before I start, I'll just give you a brief about what Son has already spoken about. It is slightly different from what Son has already spoken about because we are talking about creating inclusive employability, which includes skill development, self-employment, and wage employment we are talking about. So while we are talking about the 11th plan, we are talking about skilling 500 million in the next almost 11 years, like 500 million by 2022. If you see the unemployment, which is around 63 million and every year annually 12.8 million youths considered as the labor force entering into the Indian market, labor market for the first time, plus backlog of 49 million in our country. So, and if you see the unemployment rate, which is almost 10% in our country. So therefore, skill development and employment is very interrelated, interlinked. And skill status of our country in vis-a-vis the third world countries like Botswana, Colombia, or Korea. If you see the skill development status of Korea is almost 96%, whereas Botswana is almost 22.5% and Colombia is 28%, whereas India has only 5% skill trend in our country. So therefore, what is the journey we have developed so far? We have created India's first ever inclusive employability platform called Rozgar.in. And we have already trained, as a pilot program, we have already trained 545 youths, trained and placed. And so far, we have already received 10,000 online registration, online and offline registration across the country, just launching this site a year back. And we have got 10 corporate clients, and I'll talk about what is our strength and USP in scalability and sustainability of this project. Partnership with three government, basically two state government, government of Himachal Pradesh, government of Rajasthan, and Ministry of Rural Development for promoting employment and promoting this skill development program. 8 NGO partner because based on my 18 years of experience in the development sector, we have got a large, huge network across the country with the development sector, with the civil society organizations, especially NGO sector. And we have already got 5 branch offices. And if you see, our scalable model is also, we never invest in setting up our own office by putting up our staff. Basically, we work in two different models. One is basically franchising with our partner organizations like NGOs for sourcing and skilling and outsourcing through our own source of network. Therefore, this basically particular NCR, we have the offices, but Udaipur, Simla, Bikaner, and Bhubaneswar, we have started our office in collaboration with the NGO partners. What we are looking from as an investor, we are looking at the investor should have alignment with our vision and mission. At least they should look at a long-term perspective, at least not less than 5 years, because what in the morning, one of the speakers from the dais was talking about, because this is a social venture. So therefore, investor has to take a long-term view about this investment. This sector is particularly at an evolving stage. So therefore, many things which we are trying that has not yet been tried by either by the government or many other organizations. So therefore, we are looking at investor at least for 5 years, social and patient investor, those who have alignment with the social commitment and double bottom line. We are talking about people and profit, looking at the double bottom line and strategic direction. We are also looking at strategic direction, and the investor can play a strategic role in business expansion. Now we are a startup and we are looking from startup to the growth stage to become a high player. So in all these 3 pages, we are looking at the investor could play a strategic role, not only in investment, but also giving a strategic direction in our expansion stages. And we are talking about, if you see the financial overview also, we are talking about this year, we have already reached approximately 1 million Indian rupees. And we are looking in the next financial year, we are almost looking at around a 6.5 crore revenue. And in the next 3 years, we are looking at 100 crores as our revenue from this business model. What we are talking about, why this is, we have chosen this as a potential sector, because India's target of skilling, we have already discussed, 63 million unemployed with a rate of 9.9%. Less than 10% of the market has been tapped by the competitors, including both online and offline, what we are talking about. Like colleagues and other friends have already spoken about. Ever-growing demand in the service sector, but the market is yet to be penetrated. huge shortage of blue collar workforce due to NREGA. Because when we are talking about government policies and government initiatives, that has impact on the sourcing of the manpower for various corporate sector. So therefore, because of this Mahanarega or Mahatmagandhi Narega we are talking about, there is huge shortage of labor force or workforce in the particularly in the service sector. Attrition rate in this particular sector is very high. Blue collar workforce attrition rate is what we have recently did a basic study, and we found that 34 to 40% of the workforce they leave within 6 months' time. So therefore, even if the corporate gets this human resources, but very difficult and very challenged for them to retain this manpower. So therefore, what we are talking about time and again, employers will come back to us for hiring this manpower. And as a temping company also, we believe that once we provide this, outsource this manpower to the various corporates, then the corporate is also feeling safer, and they also think that we need not have to take that responsibility of hiring this manpower on our payroll. So therefore, they are also planning to hire Rozgar.in platform as a temping company, where not only we source this people from rural areas and urban areas, but we skill them and also we outsource them as a placement agency and also as a temping company. And if you see our annual manpower requirement so far is just 1 year down the line, we have got 7,000 per annum manpower requirement from various corporate, both corporate and the public sector. Therefore, everyone has the room to grow in this sector particularly, because this is an evolving sector and not much work has been done in this sector. So therefore, everyone has the potential to grow in this sector. What is our competitive advantage? We are talking about strong nationwide network with different, because what in the morning other speakers were talking about multi-stakeholder engagement we are talking about. Not only we have partnerships or collaborations with the NGOs, with the government, with the associations like CII and PhD Chamber of Commerce and Industry, with the academic institutions, and hopefully within 3 to 4 months time we are going to sign an MOU with one of the largest university in the country to develop their as a turnkey service provider for providing curriculum development, training, placement, as a turnkey service provider in that network. So therefore, we are talking about strong nationwide network with multi-stakeholder. Exclusive on-ground partnership and technology platform for cost-effective sourcing. Then we also work on a hub and spoke model. When we move to the next slide, you will find that we generally tend to set up our offices at the state capital, and we work with the partner at various grassroots level so that we manage this relationship through this hub and spoke model. We set up one center at the state capital and also try to manage all these partner organizations through this hub and spoke model. 1 month classroom teaching and training, and 2 months on the job training. We charge around 2500 rupees from the youths for providing those kind of training. For one example, the other example, when we place this candidate to the corporates, we take a placement fee, or when we outsource this candidates to the corporates as a temping company, we generally charge 8 to 10% service fee besides their salary, which includes their minimum wage. We ensure that they should get the minimum wage and all the socials. He liked our model, this business model, Rozgar.in platform, and he said that they would also like to explore possibility of a unique model like this to create a database in collaboration with our organizations. And as a next step, because this is just 1 year old, that is the reason why I haven't yet started exploring that possibility. But we have already made a presentation, and soon we are going to develop a partnership with NSBC.
As you mentioned, the opportunity is huge. So what are the two key challenges which you see for scaling up this your business?
One of the major challenge what we found, basically we have started this exercise in Delhi, and I am happy to share this experience with all of you, that basically our youths, whether they are underskilled or undereducated, even an illiterate guy, if you ask him to go and work for the facility management services or housekeeping services, he is not ready to go because of the social stigma what we found, and the self-esteem of the youth, because he is saying that I am not there to clean the toilets. And that is the biggest mindset what we need to change amongst the youth. And we have to realize that when we are almost 15 to 20 years back, we are talking about this hair cutting and beauty parlor. Nobody, and they were talking about it is like a caste-based vocation. But if you go to any beauty parlor, like any professional, they are working in that sector. So their toilet, cleaning the toilets, there are different kind of machines and equipments are already there. And particularly, I'll give an example. That is the reason why we have organized a skill development training with ITC Welcome Group. And one of the general manager of ITC Welcome Group, he came and he also shared this experience with the youth that when I joined as management training, I used to clean the toilet because I have to learn that experience to teach other people. So those are the major challenges. And the other one is basically sourcing this manpower. Because you will find there are so many, in terms of supply side, demand side, there is huge demand, particularly in the blue collar workforce. But finding those youths from the grassroots, from the rural areas, that is a major challenge. And that is the reason why we are talking about collaboration with the government and collaboration with the grassroots NGOs. And that is our USP and that is our strength, how we believe that okay, from 110,000 to 500,000 within 4 years time, we are going to reach.
What are the other skills you are looking at? One is housekeeping and maintenance. What are the other skills?
One is this basically this housekeeping and facility management. Other one is banking and financial services insurance. Then
what is banking financial services?
BFSI.
No, I understand.
Basically, they are working as sales executives for selling their products, insurance products, and all those things. One is that. The other one we are talking about driving. Driving, there is huge demand for the Tata or many large companies, they have also set up this kind of training school. So driving is one of the areas where we are also looking at. Then also others,
that the penetration of insurance, basically health insurance, is too low in India today. And same is availability of quality water, which Sudesh Menon a little while ago on behalf of WaterLife mentioned about. And these are like two key drivers as of, and of course, there are only 36,000 medical practitioners qualified MBBS. I would also like to mention here to the panelists that I would be running the slides a bit faster, not covering all the slides, given that I have only 8 minutes, which I just came to know, actually. So it is not a disrespect to the panel, and I'll be concentrating on more key slides. HealthPoint Services is a sustainable social business enterprise with the goal of catalytically transforming the rural and peri-urban healthcare landscape and supporting the Millennium Development Goals by uniquely combining and leveraging the benefits available via technology in ICT, healthcare, and water sectors. The specific problem, set of problems that it addresses today is, of course, contaminated water, which continues to elude more than 200,000 villages in India. The adverse physician to patient ratio, adverse means very poor, not that more physicians to the patients, actually. And then lack of diagnostics, which renders that most of the quacks in rural areas are having guesswork at best, and the patients and the clients are at risk. And of course, poor access to quality drugs, and most of the drugs peddled in rural areas may well turn out to be fake, substandard, shorter shelf life, being overcharged, and whatnot. So the HealthPoint provides a solution, which is the electronic HealthPoint clusters, wherein a HealthPoint is situated as a hub of a cluster, and water points are situated as spokes. And then drinking water, quality drinking water, quality healthcare services, doctor on call, diagnostics, genuine medicines are provided at highly affordable price points. And this model would not have been possible 4 years back because the rural